Welcome to the first ever podcast of Crude Brew Crew.
We're your host. I'm Javier, Southern California native. Like the outdoors, new to home brewing, but we're going to have fun with this.
And I'm Noel. I am not a Southern California native, but an Illinois native. But I think I've been here longer than I was in Illinois. Anyway, I started homebrewing last year, and I really enjoy it. I learned about all kinds of beers. Some of my favorite podcasts are Basic Brewing and New Brew Thursday. And I also play guitar, play drums, play keyboards a little bit, write some music, and I guess that's about it.
My name's David. I'm from Southern California. I enjoy playing music and going paintballing. I'm new to the hobby of homebrewing and hoping to learn a lot and have a fun time doing it with this crew.
My name is Matt. I'm also from Illinois and also play music. That's how I met this guy over here. And this guy, Noel. And he's the one getting me into the Crude Brew Crew to learn how to brew beer, and hopefully we have a lot of fun. We're going to play games. We're going to screw around, eat good food, drink good beer.
Yep. Well, we're gonna also include some of our techniques in home brewing, some food pairing, some gourmet cooking. We'll include any recipe that we make. We're going to give it to you, and we're basically going to have a lot of fun with it.
Exploring craft brew.
We're definitely going to explore lots of craft brew. So, without any further, let's get on with the show.
Welcome to Name That Brew, where everybody's a winner. Let's bring out our contestants. Our first contestant is Javier. Let's give him a big round of applause. And our second contestant is Matt. Let's give him a round of applause. And our last contestant, let's bring out David. David, you guys ready to play?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Yeah. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to explain four different types of beer to you, and then we're going to bring out four samples for each of you, and you are going to guess which sample is which style of beer. You think you can do that?
Definitely. Oh, yeah. Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Bring it on.
All right. Welcome back to Name That Brew. As you can see, each contestant has four beers in front of them. And as I said before, I'm going to read the four different styles of beer, and each contestant is going to name, or I should say, each contestant is going to assign that beer to the beer style that I tell you about. So, first beer style is an American Pale Ale. American Pale Ale is an American beer based on, at least originally, on the beers of British Pale Ale tradition. They are gold to amber in color, and generally their flavor and aroma is centered around the citrusy and pine character of American hops, with caramel-like malt flavors and fruity esters from the ale yeast playing a supporting role. An India Pale Ale, abbreviated IPA, is a type of ale that is lighter amber to copper in color, medium to medium high alcohol by volume, with a hoppy, bitter, and sometimes malty flavor. IPA is a style of beer that is usually included in the broader category of pale ale. It was first brewed in England in the 18th century. And our third style of beer is a Scottish ale. Scottish ales are wonderfully unique and deliciously dark, making them perfect for the colder months. The most distinctive qualities of Scottish ales are their big malty flavors and lack of hops. Using huge amounts of roasted barley in the brew and allowing it to steep for an extended period of time to caramelize gives Scottish ales their signature sweet, roasted, and malty flavors. And finally, the Belgian Dubbel is a rich malty beer with some spicy and mild alcoholic characteristics. Not as much fruitiness as the Belgian Strong Dark Ale, but some dark fruit aromas and flavors may be present. Belgian Dubbels exhibit mild hop bitterness with no lingering hop flavors. They may show traits of steely caramel flavor from the use of crystal malts or dark candy sugar. Look for a medium medium to dark body with expressive carbonation. Okay, so is everyone ready to start?
Oh yeah.
Ready to go.
Okay, go ahead. Taste the beers at your will. Any order, doesn't matter. And write down in the space provided for you that beer style. Are all of you finished? Okay, David, read me your answers. What did you get for number one?
I got the pale ale.
For number one?
For number one, I got the pale ale.
What'd you get for number two?
I got the IPA.
Are you sure you put these on the right numbers?
I don't know, but that's what I put.
What'd you get for number three?
I put the Belgian Dubbel.
And for number four?
I put the Trappist.
Well, I'm going to tell you, David, you got all the right answers in exactly the wrong order. Backwards.
Well, the crackers are good.
Okay.
Wait a minute. Wasn't it a Belgian, a Scottish, an IPA, and a pale?
No.
No, you're wrong. Hey, do I get bonus points for getting them all the right beers, though?
Okay, Matt, read me your answers. What'd you get for number one?
Don't worry, I think I'm fucking.
Trappist is number one. American Pale, number two. Pale Ale. IPA, number three. And Belgian Double, number four.
Completely wrong.
I have a cracker.
Javier, what'd you get on yours?
Number one, I got the Belgian Double. Number two is the IPA. Number three is the APA. And number four is the Belgian.
We all lose?
You all tied. Let me give you the correct answer. Number one was the Scottish Ale.
That's what I said. I said Scottish Ale.
You said Belgian
Dubbel. Yeah, he does have that.
He does have that.
You didn't read that?
He said he has it.
Okay. Number two, Belgian Dubbel.
Okay.
Number three.
IPA.
APA.
APA, yay. I got that one right.
Number four, IPA.
I got one right.
I got that wrong.
Okay. Welcome back to Name That Brew. As you saw, each one of our contestants could not correctly identify all four beers. So we're going to move into the tiebreaker section. What you see in front of each contestant is two beers and one cracker. The tall beer is a ginger peach ale that I made about 4 or 5 months ago that is not good.
Oh.
The second beer is a Fuller's
London Porter.
And what you see on the plate is an MRE cracker taken from a U.S. Army MRE. So the object is to drink both beers and eat the cracker in any order you want.
Good luck.
But before you start, you're going to open whichever beer you choose to drink first. So go ahead and open one beer each.
Sorry,
okay.
Messed up.
Now place the opener in the middle of the table, right behind the microphone. There's only one opener to open your next beer.
What about the water? Can we have any water?
You can have as much water as you want.
Okay.
But whoever finishes the two beers and the cracker first is our winner. And as you can see at the front of the table is the prize. Our prize includes two BrewDog Hardcore IPAs, one Stone Kona Brewing Macadamia Nut Porter, and one Tricar Scotch Ale. Okay, is everybody ready to begin?
Yeah!
Okay, on the count of three. 3, 2, 1, go! Drive safely and good night. Welcome back. Well, you guys didn't do very good on the on the contest. Matt did win. Matt did win.
Yeah, you know, it was easy actually. There's no competition.
Well, if you couldn't win with your brains, that's why we switched over to Braun.
Sure.
Yep.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to introduce three different beers, and then we have a surprise after that.
Surprise.
Surprise. Okay. But just to let you know what we're going to drink, on the right is Left Coast Stout. In the middle is Oskar Blues Ten Fidy. And over here we have the Espresso Porter, which is a homebrew that I made, I think, in November. And it's 10.5% alcohol.
Yes.
And
watch, that's going to get out of
this one.
Yeah, you got to keep this on the right. Know that.
Ooh,
nice. Little carbonation.
Blow your eye out.
How long has that been conditioning?
Since December. Holy cow, look at that. That's black ink.
Just like you like your
it's like dark. It's like sugar all coated on the
glass or whatever.
In any order?
Any
order? Let's start with the left. Black Magic Stout, so we're all on the same page.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Down the hatch. Mud in your eye.
Mud in your throat.
Tastes like chocolate milk.
Without the milk.
Which one?
This is the Black Magic Stout.
Black Magic Stout.
I think it's missing something.
We'll fix that later.
Okay.
I can see.
He's looking at the microphone because he's a...
Man, that is dark.
Wow. This Imperial Stout, is that like a Russian Imperial, like, or is there some, what is it, a Russian?
No, they're from Colorado.
Well, no shit.
That's close. We're going to pan to, like, the can.
It's creamier. 1050 is the creamiest.
I think they're all missing something.
We'll fix that.
You guys are all
talking.
Yeah, I'm going to go with Noel's Homebrew.
Woohoo!
It's,
I think they're
it's like a combination between both. It's got the creaminess.
agree with that.
It's got more carbonation, I think, so it makes it a little bit more refreshing, less heavy.
I think it's a little lighter. Definitely. I think it's, the Espresso Porter is definitely the lightest of the three.
I'm going to go with the Espresso Porter. It's less bitter than the other two, too.
It does have four shots of espresso, Starbucks espresso, in the, which was put, you know what, I like the left coast for taste, for flavor and everything, and for just drinking like this, I like the left coast, what is it, the Black Magic Stout.
I'm still going with yours, Noel. I'm not trying to blow smoke up your ass.
But for the surprise, I think I'm going to like the middle one best for the surprise still.
For the surprise, yes.
But I
do agree with him on yours.
They have a name.
That guy.
Matt. Please vote for him on our website.
I think he's going to get more votes after this.
Vote for Matt.
He needs a couple votes.
Yeah.
What is our website?
It's www.
Dot.
dot.
That's crudebrewcrew.com.
There you go.
Check it out and vote for your favorite.
Vote for me. Well, first for him. He needs the
votes. Actually, give Matt.
Vote for Matt and then vote for your favorite.
Definitely, that was
vote for Matt and then clear your cookies and then vote for me.
Or is that how you do it?
These guys
is that how you do
one.
It?
He doesn't need
Make
vote.
Sure you clear your cookies before your wife gets home.
All Noel's votes are by him. All
right. Let's drain these glasses because it's time for
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. As you can see, we've all re-poured our beers. Same three beers. This time we're going to see which one works best with ice cream for a beer float.
That's what was missing.
Homemade ice cream.
Is that the surprise?
That is the surprise. The recipe for this ice cream is 3 cups of cream, 1.5 cups of whole milk, a cup and 1/8 of sugar, and 1.5 tablespoons of vanilla. Put it in the ice cream maker and spun it up, threw it in the freezer. Well, if you need to know, it was 25 minutes in the ice cream maker.
But you could have figured it out. Yeah.
All right, so let's scoop them up.
Pour the beer in there.
Pour the beer.
Let's see what we can do.
Be like a bomb, watch this.
Maybe for taste them and see which one works best with ice cream.
You're supposed to, now technically when you do an ice cream with beer float, you're supposed to let it sit for about a minute. All right.
There's someone more important than us here.
It was on vibrate too. I don't know that.
Well, I didn't get anything out of it. Okay.
You're really supposed to let it sit for a minute so that the flavors can coalesce.
They can coalesce in my stomach.
All right.
Sounds good.
That's real good. Huh? This one's the dragon or the
left coast. It's a Black Magic Stout.
That very works. Good. That works.
That one's good.
That works really well.
See, this one's so like thick, it's not even going past the top layer.
Yeah.
That's good.
It's a lot easier to drink.
Oh, yeah.
But I still have a feeling that 10 Fidy is going to be the best match.
You going to film the camera filming
like,
us?
It tastes like bitter chocolate with ice cream in it. Like super bitter chocolate. Here, let me try this one again.
Next.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to have to go with the Black Magic.
Really? Here, let me try the espresso.
No.
What was the middle one?
The middle one's the Oskar Blues Ten Fidy.
Oh, yeah, this is...
Yeah, I think that's the best
winner,
one.
Winner, chicken dinner.
There you go.
That is pretty good.
Yeah. Where did we learn this recipe?
I heard it from another home brewer that said a local pub actually serves a Ten Fidy float.
Nice. So there you go. Go to your local pub.
It doesn't work with the...
tell them to make this for you.
It doesn't work with the espresso porter.
I think it does.
I think the espresso porter is too thin. Okay.
I think, the thickness of the 10 fitties actually would help too.
I think so.
I swear it almost tastes like fruity, like raspberry. And the espresso porter with ice cream smell. I don't know.
What do you guys think over there?
Well, we just got the 10 Fidy.
So is it the best then?
Well, we didn't try anything else with it.
So yes?
The 10 Fidy is pretty good.
With the ice cream, it's good.
Yeah.
I think with the stout, the left coast, it's a little, you can still taste the bitterness, which is good, but this one, it's just like a smooth, good balance.
Oh,
that's mine. I'm the mat today. Both
yeah,
for me.
Jaws.
Yeah, I like the left coast without the ice cream and the Oskar Blues Ten Fidy with it.
You're right.
Those are my choices.
I'm still going with Noel's Espresso Porter as a winner.
Thank you.
Ice cream.
Thank you.
Yeah.
But I have to agree with David.
It's still too bitter. It's still just...
The other
this
ones?
This is more like a rat, like a root beer float, really.
It is a lighter. It is definitely
I think
lighter.
One more scoop in the 10 Fidy would have been perfect.
A lot of ice cream would be good.
I think I'm going to have to agree with you.
I'm going with the espresso porter.
Espresso, yeah.
With the,
like I said, you got to let it sit a minute.
Yes, sir.
It has, and it turned the mush.
Let it coalesce.
What
let
about
the
a,
ice cream
what
inundate
about malt
itself into the... Let it...
I would say my number one choice is the espresso with the ice cream, and then number two would be the 10 Fidy, which is
number two,
the ever so classic.
Thank you, sir.
It's an espresso.
It's
a
taste. Yeah.
I think it's
Okay. Don't eat the last bit because
there's you know, I just, you know, for a viewers, and I don't want you to lose votes.
That's what we're pronunciation.
Homemade.
Okay, so two of us think that the left coast Black Magic Stout is the best to drink.
Lefties.
I'm a righty. So the best to drink. And the Oskar Blues 10 Fidy is the best for the float.
But they're wrong.
Very.
Okay.
Awesome.
Let's wrap it up.
All right, let's wrap it up.
All right, well, we had a lot of fun, I think.
Yes, we did.
We tried three great beers. We tried them all with ice cream. I was right, and David was right, too, as far as which ones were best.
Please
vote for me. These guys
right,
were...
If you insist that your beer was the worst, then I'll have to... I could agree, I guess.
It's a new world. It's third best.
Anyway.
Yeah,
right.
Okay. Well,
there's no losers.
No losers.
There's no losers.
Everybody's a winner.
Everybody's a winner here.
Okay. Yeah. And these were the losers in the game show.
Yeah, you know.
If
I'm not going to get
first, you're
not going to get too cocky about it since I got everything wrong, too.
Hey, congratulations on that.
But just being able to outdrink these two pants wasn't actually that.
Okay.
You got to be good at something if you're from Illinois.
That's true. And we're good at drinking beer.
Okay.
Fast.
All right. So check us out on the web at www.crudebrewcrew.com. And check us out on Facebook. We've got a page on Facebook. And we're also on Twitter. So,
we are on Twitter.
We are, yeah. We gotta get in with the digital.
Check out some tweets.
Some tweets.
Some sweet tweets coming at you from the Crude Brew Crew.
No, okay. We'll Tweety Bird you from that. Yes, I will. I update it whenever I feel like it. Okay, so be sure to tune in next month. Next month, we're doing a Pete's Wicked Clone, which is a brown ale. A Hickory Smoked Chili. And then we're going to see how it fares against a couple wines, too. Which
cool.
I'm pretty sure the beer is going to beat it.
Maybe we'll play some more games?
Maybe.
Definitely.
Next month is a holiday month.
Sure. Say anything? Maybe we'll, you know.
And I'm not talking about Cinco de Mayo.
Maybe we'll make the pot a little sweeter, too.
Hey, yeah. That's right. It is Drinco de Mayo.
There you go. All right.
Your ice cream's good.
Thank you. All right, well, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next month.
Woo-hoo! All right, quiet on the set, and roll sound, roll camera.
Boing.
That's how they do it.
This is homebrew. Look at the.
Not that meme.
This will go in the outtakes for sure.
Okay, Javier, when you come out, or when each of you come out, just I need you just to run past the corner here.
All right, now leave.
My mistake was eating the cracker first.
Okay, let's shut cameras off.
Dude, you didn't get anywhere on that, man. You got nowhere.
I tried to eat the cracker.
What were you thinking?
That's funny.
You have some Dora the Explorer music?
Milk a snake.
Do you have any?
Never liked you, Noel. Just so you know.
Well, that thing's warm as hell.
Good coming up.
Well, that's one way to get rid of bad beer. Hey, get back in the camera shot.
I'm drinking 40.
I think I see the winner already.
Yeah.
I think Matt's taking...